Okay, guys, doing a bit of an anniversary tribute. Not even a tribute, just a video to commemorate the occasion. To be honest, I don't actually remember Ayrton Senna dying because my father has always watched Formula One on the telly, and I used to watch it with him when I was quite little. Well, not watch it with him as such, but just sort of be around when it was on the TV. And I actually don't remember, to be honest. My only real prevailing memory of Formula One from my childhood is those big chunky rear tyres and Ferraris whizzing around because I had a couple of toy ones that were about this big. So yeah, there was no I remember where I was when it happened for me because I don't. I was only 8, wasn't that big on it. I did quite like that Senna film that came out a couple of years ago. Because it was interesting. I mean, you know, he's a very interesting guy. I do kind of feel like with him, they took a very good opera and then only let one of the characters sing because, you know, it was a very fascinating kind of time in Formula One. There's a lot of interesting people around, things happening, and yeah, but the movie kind of made it all very one, I won't say one-sided, but a bit of a narrow viewpoint, I think. Still a good movie, though. Whoa! Fucking wheel. Give it another go. Come on, you fucker. I'm trying to concentrate on not eating the barrier now. I really don't like that when I concentrate my forehead, there's this funny wrinkly thing that makes me look like a Klingon. Usually lose traction there. I don't think I was going fast enough this time. Or this time. Oh god, look at that. Whoa! Another bar! Oh well. Had to copy the man. Copy the great man somewhere along the line. Oh! Wow. This thing is fairly barreling along and I don't really have the skill to keep up with it. Oh god. Yeah. Alright. Ah! But anyway, what I thought might be a laugh is if I just shut up for once and let the great man speak for himself while I, instead of drive really, really well like he did, before we just amble around a bit and crash into things like I usually do, so I'm getting some music cranking. Off we go.
That day, I suddenly realized that I was no longer driving it conscious, and I was in a different dimension for me. The circuit for me was a tunnel, which I was just going, and I realized I was well beyond my conscious understanding. I am very competitive. I think any racing driver that gets to Formula One has in its personality a lot of competitiveness. I particularly believe to be extremely competitive in anything I do. But it depends where you are and what you're doing and what is your state of mind. If I'm on holiday, off season, it's a different way of living, totally, than when you do interviews, when you testing during the season, racing, competing during the season. You have to allow yourself a different mental approach, a different way of looking the day and night. And only that way I find possible to get the necessary equilibrium to then give everything I have when it really matters. But in normal things, I'm competitive. I like to compete and I like to do well, I like to be the best. More power to go through difficulties and to create a little more in situations where It is the ability you have to imagine and create and put it in reality. Maybe we have a little bit more. So when he decides to go to Europe from South America, from Brazil, you must have in yourself a lot of guts and a lot of determination to succeed. I think that is a common
that's pretty cool
feeling in all of us.
Going towards the first corner, I just chased him then, and he opened the gap. And knowing me, like he does know, he must realize that if there was a gap, I was going to try to overtake him. And under those circumstances, he should never have opened a gap in the first corner and then come back again. Because if he happened just to touch, and have a wing damage or a wheel flat tire, he had everything to lose.
So,
and under those circumstances, my understanding was that he would never move against me in the first corner. And I was very surprised when I found myself with him moving the car over mine.
So in that case, you were calculating that he would give way, that he would let you through.
Of course, he would not close the way he did. Mm-hmm. From the moment he made the initial room, he would not come back and close the door again.
A calculated risk.
Of course.
Okay.
You should know that by being a racing driver, you are under risk all the time. By being a racing driver means you are racing with other people. And if you no longer go for a gap that exists, you're no longer a racing driver. Because we are competing. We are competing to win. And the main motivation to all of us is to compete for a victory. It's not to come third, fourth, fifth, or sixth.
But hasn't that
right?
always been the case?
Sorry?
Hasn't that always been the case of all the great champions?
Absolutely. But I think it's all irrelevant. All what you're saying, Jack, is really irrelevant. Because I'm a driver that won more races than anybody over the past 3 years. I'm a driver that has been on pole position more than anybody in history. And I'm a driver that won 2 titles over the past 3 years.
Shit.
And I don't think how, I cannot comprehend how you can try to turn things around to say that I've been involved in more accidents than anybody, because that is not true as well. I don't really understand the point.
No, I'm sorry, I don't agree with that.
Then you should go back. You should go back 10 years from the date of today. And look not only the leaders, you should look the middle field and the backfield drivers.
I speak of the champions.
And find by yourself that perhaps what you say is not quite right.
Well, I would be happy to go back with you and go through the Fangios and the Clarks and the Lauders and the Fittipaldis.
You only have to go back 10 years, the modern Formula One. That's what we are talking about.
So you feel totally comfortable that the technique of driving that you use has not in any way developed into a situation where the gap opens up and it's taken spontaneously? Because you do go for gaps, and we all have
when
done it in our
career. When there is a gap, it's designed for being in a competition at a very high level, with cars going so close that as they go today, with the same horsepower, with the same level of grip, with the same load aerodynamic. You all know, with the different circuits where it's very difficult for overtaking because the circuits are designed not in an appropriate manner for overtaking maneuvers. You either commit yourself as a professional racing driver that is designed to win races, or you come second, or you come third, or you come fifth. And I'm not designed to come third, fourth, or fifth. I race to win.
Yes!